أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد أما بعد we continue our thoughts about the كلمات من القرآن words from the Quran and we still in the beginning of سورة البقرة ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. So التقوى المتقين وقى العربي تعني الوقاية جاءت من الوقاية أن تجعل بينك وبين ما تخاف أو تحذر حاجزا أو مسافة وقى is to protect and to make a barrier between you and something you fear, something that you don't want to get hurt by. Al-Taqwa, we have also, and subhanAllah, we use this concept. Number one, like in deen, when you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, تجعل بينك وبين غضب الله حاجزا, عقوبة الله حاجزا, you make a barrier between you and anger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you have taqwa Allah, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, you have a room not to fall in a sin or doing a mistake. And same way when you taqun nar, fear the hellfire, meaning to make, you know, a safety margin between you and the hellfire. And we have this beautiful hadith, Rasulullah, when he speaks about al-halal ubayyin, al-haram ubayyin, that halal is clear, al-haram is clear, wa baynahuma umurun mutashabihat, la ya'lamuhunna kathirun minan nas. In between, there is a lot of gray area, doubts, that not many people knows about it, or what is halal, what's haram. So the Prophet said, فَاتَّقُوا الشُّبُهَاتِ, don't be in this gray area, take safety of margin. And he gave a beautiful example about أَلَا وَإِنَّ لِكُلِّ مَلِكٍ حِمَى. He gave an example from the Bedouin environment. He said, back then, the masters or the leaders of any tribe, they will have a hima. Hima means like an area where nobody can get his animals to be fed or to eat in this area. Mar'a, like a land where you have a lot of grass and food. So any normal person will keep his animals far from this area. So you don't keep your animal just on the border of the land, because if he cross the border, or the animal cross the border, sorry, I used to say he, because I don't think it is good. It's something in my mind. So the animal, when the animal cross the borders, the leader of this tribe will capture the animal and will take it for him. So what do you think the Bedouin will do? They will keep their animals, huh? 1 kilometer away, 2 kilometers away. So if one animal by mistakes came close to the land, he has enough time to run and capture him and bring him safe. SubhanAllah, it's a beautiful example. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is the same. When we, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us, and then Allah, Rasulullah said, أَلَا وَإِنَّ حِمَ اللَّهِ مَحَارِمٌ. This, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى, Allah has the highest example. This land, similar to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is haram. So everything Allah said haram, it's similar to this land. So don't come close to it. Leave a safety margin. Okay, so this is the meaning of taqwa, is to leave a margin between you and haram, between me and haram. And subhanAllah, in our life, in our modern life, you know, when you drive your car, you know, they say you keep 2 cars between you and the car in front of you. The reason is, if he break all of a sudden, you have enough time to stop, right? So this margin that we leave between cars, it's kind of taqwa that we implement over our life. In you know, when they build a house like this or a place like this, they calculate the roof and they said, you know, the columns will carry say 10 tons, but we will build it to carry 50 tons. So this safety margin, this extra margin, is kind of a of taqwa. So subhanAllah, the concept of taqwa, and this is just the first يعني attributes or first act of human in the Quran. In the Quran, ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب العربي هدى للمتقين. The first يعني أول صفة ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى عن الإنسان المسلم المفلح هو التقوى. The first thing Allah سبحانه وتعالى مش is to have this protection, to have this barrier, to have this safety margin from between you and this, and something you don't like. And we implement it in our life in many aspects. You will find this margin, safety of margin concept all the time in our life. The chairs you sit on, you weigh like 90 kilograms or 80 kilograms, it's designed to be 200 kilograms. Why? We have margin. We have this kind of taqwa. The second word today, inshallah, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. يؤمنون. And this is one problem in English, and if I'm wrong, someone correct me. يعني بالعربي لما أقول أنا يصدق ويؤمن. بالعربي في فرق ولا لا؟ In Arabic, we have a difference between the word يصدق, to believe. You say يصدق, صدق, to say the truth. And يؤمن, to believe. But both of them in English, we say believe, right? Is there any translation for يصدق and يؤمن? When I tell you the truth, I say, tell me the truth. We say in Urdu, صدق. Yes? الصدق, right? So, but, and we have إيمان. So, from Urdu to English, how do you translate صدق? يصدق, if someone saying the truth, and someone يؤمن, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, for us, there is a difference between يصدق and يؤمن. But in English, I know only believe. And this is because of my lack of knowledge in the beautiful English that we use in everywhere now. الأصل في عملية الإيمان التصديق. أن أنا أصدق. يعني this is the root meaning. You say something, I believe you. You saying the truth. It has nothing to do with the إيمان yet. إيمان came from the root آمنة. Security. So a man is secure. Yes? When you live in peace, you live in security, you live in secure place, this kind of amen, safe. So you subject to believe, but iman related to security, to feel safe, right? But why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Quran use the word iman to replace the word tasdiq or yusaddiq? And subhanAllah, this is kind of think about your iman in Allah, in deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a treasure. The iman, al-iman billah, wal-i'taqad al-sahih fillah, huwa kanz. If you have a treasure, where do you put the treasure? In a safe place, right? Because the iman and the aqidah in our hearts, it is so secured that no one can take it away from you. This is why, subhanAllah, we use the word iman. It is so safe. You know, how many Muslims who practice their deen? Every day they come to pray, they learn their deen, and they, you know, and someone will come and talk to them about something else and create doubt in their hearts. It's almost impossible. And this is why many times when I met many people, I was in Africa, and I met one guy in Kenya, said, I was a Muslim. So I asked him, how many rak'ah you do for us? He said, three. I said, you are not Muslims, and you became non-Muslims. You know, you were not Muslim before. يعني أنت لم تكن مسلما ثم أصبحت غير مسلم. There is nothing new. So, but if someone has a true iman in his heart, he really believe Islam, believe in Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, believe in Allah, believe in so and so and so, especially al-ghayb, the unseen, it will be so safe and secure that nobody will take it the same way you have a treasure in a safe or in a bank or something that nobody can take it away. So this is a relationship. So this is a relationship between at-tasdiq, to say the truth and you believe, and al-iman, and safe and secure and so on. And this is why it is very important when we raise our kids, when we even learn to take the people from the level of at-tasdiq ila level al-iman, to take them from the level of listening to the truth, believing the truth, to a safe level, which is the iman is so secured in their heart that nobody will take it away from them. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. جزاكم الله خير والسلام عليكم.